Does. These guys have a belly full of just animosity, dude.
Now entering the ring, fighting out of the red corner, weighing in at 225 pounds and trained by Jeff Wattola, John Cutler!
I'll let you die my Wu-Tang style.
Bring the motherfucking ruckus! Bring the motherfucking ruckus!
Oh, yes, dude,
bring
let's go.
Bring the motherfucking ruckus!
Dude, all right, so, all right, now all walkout songs, you know, we are pretty... critical
of a hype burst.
Dropping hard F-bombs in the House of Blues.
Yeah, so we've been told that on the pay-per-view stream, you guys can't hear the lockout songs. I'll tell you, this
must say every bad word they're saying,
yeah,
dude. No, but it's like hard F-bombs. It's awesome. This dude's all hyped up. Good stuff. Love the old school rap, dude.
Please welcome, fighting out of the blue corner, weighing in at 230 pounds, fighting out of Alton Street Boxing and Fitness and trained by Todd Paris, Jonathan, the Nashville Smoker, Pose!
All right, just another banger, like old school rap punk, but again, his nickname is the Nashville Smoker. The nicknames have been good.
Yeah, but I don't even think he's from Nashville. I have no idea where
he's
from.
But he's a restaurateur. Maybe he's like into barbecue.
Yeah, that's
cares,
fair.
Dude,
you know, I'll tell you. Awesome. So we talk a lot about Jonathan Post, cornerman. That's Todd Buster Paris. Todd has an interesting approach to corner work. Matt, what is he known for now at this point in time?
Puts a straw in the water bottle.
Is brought to you by our
we'll talk more about it. We got plenty of time for
Rivers Edge, Priotto Lane and Associates Limited.
Third man in the ring for this bout is Steve Clark's better half. Tom Clark is
better half.
No, don't tell me. I don't want either one of them beating the crap out of me. So, no, Tom's great. Me and Marco like to think we're the second best boxing duo.
We're the Wish.com version of the Clark brothers. We wish we were them.
That's right.
We're getting there eventually.
The dollar store version.
So you got the heaviest men in the ring tonight at 225 pounds and 230 pounds. You have a fight later in the night. It's 6 1/2 dozen the other, 235 and 215. But these are some big, big men. And we saw them at Media Day. They throw bombs.
Yeah, so what I remember, I do remember it being pretty competitive, but I do remember they were both big punchers.
Yeah.
I'll be totally honest with you. For once ever, I'm not familiar with John Cutler's corner. I don't recognize the two. And I don't mean that to be a slight. I'm just, generally speaking, I'm pretty familiar.
Great jab by Cutler right away. Good right hand by Post.
I think this is going to turn out to be a good scrap. It looks like Cutler's flaring that right hand just over top. And he just
great
went home for
uppercut.
Oh, he stung him. He hurt him.
He's hurt.
Yep. Great call by Tom Clark. Is that an eight count?
Yep.
Right off the bat. Now, this is Post opportunity to say, look, I'm totally fine. Yep. He's doing the right thing.
Yep.
Bouncing his step, you know. Showing
what
that
happens
he's fine.
If you get caught early and you're a big guy? If Cutler wants to come out guns blazing, he might get caught with something hard here.
Both these men are also in the Masters division. And with
great right hand, he's hurt.
He just absolutely face planted. If the feed cut out, it looks like Cutler is extremely celebratory. But if we're being totally honest, this fight is academic at this point.
Yeah.
They're allowing them to continue.
They're going to take a point. Are they going to take a point? No,
it's
box.
Closed.
Okay.
This fight is a wrap.
Yeah.
Unless Jonathan Post does something absolutely dramatic, which he might. He's a big dude. Or Cutler, rather. I'm sorry. If Cutler can come back, Post. Jesus, between John and John, they're killing me. If Post can come back, which he is, by the way, and weather a storm, you know, the thing is, Cutler's finding that right hand both over top as an overhand right and as a rear uppercut. Yep. We'll see. A little ugly inside, which actually bodes well for Post.
Yeah, he hurt him again. His fight's very close to being stopped.
Yep, there's another eight count. Now, if they...
Yeah, they have to wave off. That's the right thing to do.
That's the fight, folks.
Yep. And again, you know, Jonathan Post is going to argue, he's going to claim. It's just a matter that he doesn't know the sport enough. He doesn't understand how hurt, how rocked he was. Tom did a phenomenal job as a referee. You have to stop that fight.
Everyone always accuses us of being kiss asses for USA Boxing New England, but tell me how you could officiate that fight better.
No,
he called it exactly.
Impossible.
And not for nothing, he gave Post every opportunity in the world to come back.
Yep.
You know? Big, tough dude, you know? And it sucks to lose, but hopefully he does it with a smile, you know? Giving pleasantries in the corner just as they should, you know? And also, as far as Cutler's celebration, it wasn't classless or anything. He's excited. The House of Blues packed. There's like 1,700 people here going
nuts. You know, Matt and I, when we're behind the call, we forget sometimes that it's, you know, first time out guys here. It's a charity.
And also what they're fighting for,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly. They're raising tremendous amounts of money for cancer research.
So how could you not be excited? You train, you know, a lot of these guys, this is it. This is their one fight, you know? So when you land an absolute grenade on a dude that's 6'3", 230, and he face plants, you get a little animated. You know what I mean?
100%.
Good fight. Just gross fight so far. Real mean. That's pretty much as advertised, you know? Tough.
Official decision
tough
coming up.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has called a stop to this contest at 1 minute and 50 seconds in the first round. For your winner in the red corner, John Cutler.
Yeah, barely, motherfucker.